Baseball from the Lone Star State. Interleague Baseball on MLB The Show. It's the New York Mets taking on the Houston Astros.
And now,
and we'll be back with the first pitch right after this.
2022 Houston Astros.
So just about set, and stepping in is the speedy Brandon Nimmo. And a 1-1. Fouled off to the right. The 1-2. Pitch misses there. The count now 2-2. Next offering upstairs.
Full count.
Next pitch is popped up. Maldonado gets under it. And out number one on the grab.
That was a good pitch to hit right down the heart of the plate. Had pretty good timing on it. Just got underneath it a little bit and popped it up.
Number six.
Starling Marte up to hit.
Marte.
One down, base is empty. And down on strikes. That's the second out. Here's Francisco Lindor.
The shortstop.
The wind of the pitch.
Lindor.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. This to center field. McCormick moving under it. Makes the catch, inning over. Back here in Houston, standing in is the power-hitting second baseman, Jose Altuve. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four. Now Michael Brantley steps in.
The left fielder, Michael Brantley.
Next offering is in for a strike. Squirts away a little bit. Altuve aboard here at first with nobody out. Next pitch is outside.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. And now it's Alex Bregman.
The third baseman.
Alex Williams with a move to Bregman. First. Altuve back safely. The pitch. That one missed. The 2-1. And that one missing low. Swing and a miss. 3-2 now. Kick the 3-2. Swing and a bouncer. Fires over to first. And they get Bregman for the out. Now it's Yordan Alvarez. He's someone that really beats up on right-handed pitching. The lefties, however, give him a little bit more trouble.
Alvarez.
Well, with this many pitches thrown here in this first inning, I mean, you're giving the other team a really good look. He's going to have to find a way to get some weak contact, maybe a swing and miss, get into that dugout and hit the reset button.
And a swing and a miss, and that's that. Back here in Houston, top of the second, and stepping in for New York, Pete Alonso. Next one is off the plate. 3-2 now.
Full count.
The other way, and he beats the shift. Takes the turn. He's digging for second. Oh, he throws it away.
That was it. The designated hitter.
Jeff McNeil stands in.
McNeil.
Runner leads away at second. In the air, right field. Tucker settles under it and makes the grab. Runner tagging for third. And he's in safely at third with one out.
That is it. The third baseman, Eduardo Escobar.
The pitch. That to right. Tucker should have this one. And puts the squeeze on that. Runner tags from third. He's in on the sacrifice fly. And it's 1-0.
Well, it's a nice job right there. It's always great when you can get on the scoreboard first. Just good situational hitting to bring him home from third right there.
Line drive, base hit.
Showed some really nice patience in that at bat. Worked himself into a good count. Off the bat, it was headed for the gap all the way. And as a hitter, you love seeing those as you take your first couple of steps out of the box. You know you've got some real estate to run on, and such a good feeling. Nice liner into the gap right there.
Here's Luis Guillorme. The next offering misses. 2-1. There goes the runner. Strike in there. And that's a stolen base. Not even close. Swing and a ball popped up. Altuve makes the catch. And that'll do it. Bottom half of inning number 2. And stepping in for the Astros, Yuli Gurriel. The wind and the pitch. Gurriel gets a piece. Righty delivers. Oh, that got away from him. And he's going to reach on a hit by pitch to lead off the inning.
Oh, Boog, I know how much you love free stuff, and this offense has to love a free base runner to start this inning, even if it hurts a little bit. We'll see if they can do anything with it.
And now 2 balls and a strike. Nobody out. Runner at first. Line drive. That's a base hit out of the left center field. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. The ball absolutely jumped off the bat on that swing. Kind of made my eyes light up. And the data we're getting doesn't disappoint in the slightest. 116 miles per hour exit velocity. Tell you what, that will do the job.
And that one is lifted in the air. Marte pulls it down. Runner tags up for third. Into third now. So runners at the corners and one out. So up next, Jeremy Pena.
That's shortstop. Jeremy Pena.
Ball to strike. Swung out, belted. That one's carrying. Pulls it in on the warning track. Runner tags for home. He'll score the sac fly. It's 1-1. Martin Maldonado up to hit. This is a guy who is very highly regarded defensively. Fun to watch him control stuff behind the plate. Good game caller, good at framing, but it's that big arm that really stands out. Next pitch is outside. Yeah, the 2-1 hammered but foul.
See how the catcher wanted that pitch up and in. Want to try to tie him up. That's the one thing we're seeing, that high fastball. You have to get it up there because of how hitters have changed their swings.
2-2. Got him. Good job of damage control right there. And welcome back. New inning getting started. Here's the catcher, Tomas Nido. Kicks and fires. Good eye right there.
Three balls, one strike.
On the ground to third. One up, one down. Back to the top of the lineup. Here's Brandon Nimmo.
The center fielder, Brandon Nimmo.
3-1 now. Swings over the top of that one.
Man, he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
And he walked him.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch, and I tell you what, he earned that walk.
Here's Starling Marte. Pickoff move to first, and he's back in safely. Tied up here in the early going. Falling behind, 2-1. First offering, runner goes. And he hits a ground ball right side. Gurriel takes it himself. No chance at the double play with the runner in motion. Now here is Francisco Lindor. 0-1 with a flyout.
Francisco Lindor.
The 1-1. Fought off foul. Nimmo at second with two down. Base knock center field.
Here comes the runner.
He will score. It's 2-1.
Mission accomplished there as he picks up the RBI to give him the lead. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride low, out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off it.
The throw in time to get him, and that does it for the inning. Back here at the ballpark, digging in, Jose Altuve. Right-hander kicks, deals. That one off the mark, 2-1.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
2-1 pitches in there, and the count is even. Swing and a miss, struck him out. One gone, bottom of the third inning. Michael Brantley stands in. He's kind of an outlier, especially when guys are consciously sacrificing contact to deliver power. Swings and sends a rocket to right. Marte makes the catch, and there's two away. Two outs, base is empty. Now it's Alex Bregman.
Alex Bregman.
Here's a 1-1. Drilled out towards left center field. That's well struck. That's back. Pulls it in on the warning track. As we go to the top of the fourth. So now here's the Mets DH, Jeff McNeil. Next offering misses, and it's 2-1. That's to third. Throw in the dirt, and he can't come up with it. So up next for New York, Eduardo Escobar. Drove in a run with a sac fly his first time up. And a foul ball. McNeil gets his lead at first. Nobody out. One, two now. Got him. and one gone. Here's Mark Canna, one for one with a single so far.
Mark Canna.
On the ground, left side, 6-4-3, double play, and the inning is over. Welcome back. Now it's the DH, Yordan Alvarez. Left-hand hitter waits. Check swing, but he went too far. That's strike two. Next pitch, not close, up high. Bounce to the left side. Toss to Alonso. One out in the bottom of the fourth.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
And now 2-2. To the right side. Alonso takes it to the bag. Already two gone here in the home fourth. Here's Kyle Tucker.
Right fielder.
Pretty good job on the mound in this one, Siggy. It feels like we've seen a lot of off-balance swings.
Yep, just one free pass, and obviously he's not a big strikeout guy, but he gets soft contact and he gets outs.
Next pitch is popped up. And that's the inning. Ready now for the fifth inning, and stepping in for New York, Luis Guillorme. The wide to kick the pitch. Out towards right center field, and that will fall. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
These days, most outfielders play pretty deep, and I'm not sure if that was a factor there or not, but off the bat, you're thinking it's going to be a pop out, and it just kind of nestled into that spot where no one was able to get to it.
Next one misses. Ball two.
2-2.
Now a high fly ball out to left center. Brantley right there to make the grab. One down. Back to the top of the Mets order at the plate. Brandon Nimmo. The 1-1. That one fouled off. The pitch towards first, and that one finds its way through. They fired in quickly, so it's first and second with only one away. The right Starling Marte up now for Starling. The Mets.
Marte.
Here's the pitch. It's a double steal. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Double play ball to second. Off balance feed. There's one. Not in time at first. It's a fielder's choice.
If he can get through this one, put up a zero, this will help in his outings to come.
Two on, two outs. There's a strike. Guillorme on third. Marte at first. Two out of the inning.
He's gone off speed. He needs to elevate here with two strikes out of the zone.
Kicks and deals. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. Urquidy picks over, and he's back in easily. Two two now. Next offering is outside.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
And there's ball four.
Well, interesting. He went with the off speed and walked the hitter. Man, you got to challenge the guy with the fastball.
Two outs, bases full. And now it's the polar bear, Pete Alonso. And a pitch.
Logan, situations like these, the air can get really thin up there at the plate. Got to find a way to breathe and slow everything down.
Next pitch is downstairs.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with a 3-1 count.
And a 3-2. And a foul ball. Here comes a 3-2. Line drive. Makes the play, and it's out number three. Back here at Minute Maid Park, ready to go for the last half of the inning. And now it's going to be Chaz McCormick. Out to short, base hit. So a man on base to start the inning.
The batter,
no outs,
three.
Runner at first.
Shortstop,
Jeremy Peña up next for the Astros.
Peña.
And here it comes. That one lifted to left. That's back there. Pulls it in on the warning track. Martin Maldonado up next for the Astros.
The catcher, Martin Maldonado.
The 1-1. That one misses. 2-1.
Everyone here understands just how quickly things could change.
Next pitch downstairs. 3-1.
With 2 strikes. May see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of a double play here.
Popped up left side. Lindor settles underneath it. Puts it away for the out. And next to hit for Houston, Jose Altuve.
Now
he's 0-1.
Second baseman, Jose Altuve.
The 1-1.
Good speed on the base pass. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or a run and hit.
Next offering is down low. Chris, with that distraction and the speedy guy at first, he's in a favorable hitter's count.
Well, if nothing else, I mean, this is a great spot for a hitter to be in.
Williams keeping him close. Fouls one away, and now 3-2.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score.
And he deals. In the air, right side of the infield. And that will end the inning. Astros go to the pen, and here comes Ryan Stanek. This guy can bring it velocity-wise.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
And welcome back. Now at the plate, Jeff McNeil. The next pitch misses, and it's 2-1. Right-handed reliever, and that one upstairs. That one misses, so a leadoff walk.
Pretty easy walk right there. Last pitch wasn't even much to think about.
Eduardo Escobar, El Caballo up to him. Runner at first with no outs here. And a swing and a miss. Now one away. Mark Canna up now for the Mets.
The left fielder, Mark Canna.
Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah.
A
little slider action.
Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. Marqueta takes him deep, and they boost their lead. It's 4-1. Base is empty, one away. Here's the second baseman, Luis Guillorme. And a 2-1 on the way. And it's fouled away. Now all even up. Right side. Altuve handles it. That's it out. Two outs. Base is empty. Tomas Nido up now for the Mets. Nido. Ball and a strike. Just missed. And he grounds one to the right side. Sends it to first. That's out number three. Here in Houston. Well, we go bottom six. Now it's going to be Michael Brantley. Now that's smacked to right center. He can't get there. It's a base hit. Into second easily with a leadoff double.
Well, patience and discipline paid off right there as he got into an advantage count.
As soon as that one shot off his barrel, he was thinking extra bases. Really nice job of getting the bat out front, but not hooking around it or rolling over.
Oh, this one high and deep, way back there. And gone! Alex Bregman with a shot to the opposite field. And they throw a pair on the board. It's 4-1. Taking over on the mound for the Mets, Jason Schreeb. He has a great slider with tons of movement. So next up for Houston, Yordan Alvarez. This guy has turned into a beast. Next pitch off the play. And now 3-1. Kicks and fires. Foul ball. Good battle here. About to be the eighth pitch of the at-bat. Left-hand batter waits. This one ripped, but foul to the right. And a pitch. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
When you go that deep into an at bat, the hitter usually comes out on top.
No outs. Runner at first. Yuli Gurriel up next for the Astros. And a 1-1. And there's a foul ball. Swing and a high fly ball out there towards left field. Canna makes the play, and there's one away. And stepping in for the Astros, Kyle Tucker.
The right fielder, number
definitely
30.
Wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball on the ground in the infield. Should be an inning-ending double play.
Here's a 1-1. And that one fouled off. Ball and two strikes. Stays alive. Hit on the ground might be two. Quickly to second for one. And that's two. A new pitcher in the game, Phil Maton. And his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance.
Maton.
We go to the top of the seventh, and now here's a speed threat. Outfielder Brandon Nimmo. Next offering is in for a strike.
One ball, two strikes.
The 1-2. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And now one away. And next for the Mets, Starling Marte.
Marte.
At the belt and fires. Good eye right there.
This is a really good feeling for a hitter. At this point in the ball game, you know that they don't want to walk you, so you're going to get a pitch to hit. You just better not miss it.
3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
One run game, one out, one on. Swing and a high fly ball, pretty well struck right field. That's back there. Pulls it in on the warning track. And next will be the Mets cleanup hitter, Pete Alonso. Got to be careful with a slugger like this because he could turn it into a three-run game in the blink of an eye. The 1-1. Good eye in that spot. Out towards left center. Ping racing over to make the catch. On the mound now, Drew Smith. The offense will need to be ready for the breaking stuff. He's got a great curveball.
Smith.
Back here at the ballpark, and the batter now, Chaz McCormick. Looking to get the tying run on base.
You know, this guy's great speed is in the back of that pitcher's mind. If he can get on, it's going to give him one more thing he's got to think about.
Righty to the plate. Lined into right. One away.
Well, off the bat, it looked like they might get that tying run on base, maybe even extra bases. No dice, though. A little unlucky on that one.
Jeremy Peña.
Two-one pitch is in there, and the count is even.
That big curve inside is a pitch that can buckle you a little bit. Looks like a fastball out of hand, and then just drops over that inside part of the plate.
Ground ball left side, sneaks through, base hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
Now batting.
And that's the hit for Houston, Martin Maldonado.
Maldonado.
Moves first. Pena back in on a dive. Pena over at first with one away. And it is 2-1. Next offering is downstairs.
Well, with the amount of pitches that can end up in the dirt, a good secondary lead doesn't have to get away from the catcher. But if you're anticipating based off the trajectory, get yourself in the scoring position.
On the ground, could be two. Escobar with the throw to first. Two away.
Well, there's a lot riding on that at bat right there. Nice job of the pitcher to bear down, make the pitch, get the ground ball. Excellent piece of work.
Jose Altuve.
two outs.
Well, Boog, if you're that base runner at second base, you want to be quiet out there. Not bouncing around, not distracting your teammate, the hitter. Make sure that he can clearly focus on that pitcher and that release point.
The 2-2 now. On the ground, out to short. Gets it to first, and that is the inning. Back here in Houston, and now the DH, Jeff McNeil. Here's a 1-1. Way outside, and a count 2-1. That one is absolutely belted. That's back. Makes the catch up against the wall.
Well, those can be pretty fun as an outfielder. Got to put it into his highest gear and go a long way to track that one down. Nothing better than that. You feel like a wide receiver playing football.
The 1-1. Swing and a miss, and he was fooled. And that one wrapped foul. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat. Mark Ken up now for the Mets. The pitch.
Two balls, one strike.
And a swing and a miss.
Kelly just threw that fastball by him, elevated, and if you're not looking up in that location, very difficult to catch up to, especially with that velocity.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. Here's a 2-2. Swing and a ball ripped out towards right center field. That'll touch down for a hit, and it bangs up against the wall. Safe at second with a double. Third hit for him this afternoon.
Having himself a really nice game at the plate. I love the approach he had right there with that pitch. Not trying to do too much, but still looking to drive it, and that's exactly what he's able to do into the opposite field gap for the double.
The next offering misses, and it's 3-2. And that one fouled off. And the right-hander deals. Got him looking. Third out, and that ends the frame. They go with one of their more experienced arms in this spot, Seth Lugo. And he'll work on holding this lead.
Seth Lugo.
Welcome back, and Michael Brantley is going to come up to hit. On the ground, right side, Guillorme hoping to pick it up. Tosses to first, and that's one away as the leadoff man is out in the eighth.
Good two-seam action right there, running away from the batter. Rolled over it, got the ground out.
The 1-1.
You get to this part of the order, there's some pop there, but more likely there's some base hits. So very important to be patient. Let the pitcher walk you, if he will.
That one in for a strike, 2-2. And he gets Bregman. And there are two down. Here's Yordan Alvarez.
Number 44, designated hitter. Yordan Alvarez.
The 1-2. Pitch in the dirt, 2-2.
They tried to get him to go, chase the pitch down and away, but he wouldn't bite.
Swing and a miss, and that is that. New arm out of the bullpen, Brian Abreu.
Number 66, Brian Abreu.
All set to start the ninth in this one. And now the catcher comes up to hit. Tomas Nido. And a pitch. And he walked him. Brandon Nimmo digs in now.
Center fielder, number 9. Brandon.
One run game here at the top of the ninth. Right field down the line, and that one slices foul. Here comes a pitch. Stays alive. And the pitch. And now it's filled up. On the ground to the left. And a base hit. Lead runner holds up. They're at first and second with nobody out.
He got a backdoor breaking ball. Really easy to give up on that pitch, but he stayed on it and shot it right back in the direction it was breaking from. Really nice job of letting it travel.
Foul ball there. Crowd locked in right now. One run game here in the ninth. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And one out now. Now up to hit Francisco Lindor.
Well, both sides equally as strong. So not a good time to try to turn him around with a relief pitcher and put him on the other side of the plate.
Started to go to 1-2. A check on it to third. No swing. He held up. Clyde Washington with the call there. The pitch. Fought off foul. Nido at second. Nimmo over at first with one away. Out there to center. McCormick on his way over. Two away down. So first and second with two outs. Stepping in the long ball threat, Pete Alonso. And that'll load the bases.
Well, the stage has been set for this offense, Boog. It's all about creating opportunities, and this is one of them right here.
And now here's Jeff McNeil. Bases loaded, two down. Swings and misses. Now 1-2.
I guess you throw it that hard, you can get away with locations like that right down the middle. But I still think it's a dangerous pitch. Don't want to do it again.
Popped up. Base hit. One run is in. Now two runs score. And they lead by three.
Picks himself up a couple of ribbies. Just a bloop hit behind third right there. And that's a really tough play for a third baseman or shortstop to get to. And the same for the left fielder. So he just found a perfect place to drop that one in right there.
A new arm into the game. The righty, Seth Martinez. Eduardo Escobar up now for the Mets. The 2-1. This one popped up, middle of the infield. Pena has this one sized up, and that is that. So they turn to Edwin Diaz out of the pen, and he'll feature a hard slider to work off his fastball. So bottom of the ninth, and stepping in for the Astros, Yuli Gurriel. And the righty deals. Just a weak fly ball this time. Marte, as he glides to his left. Nice grab on the run. And there's one away.
The right fielder.
So digging in, Kyle Tucker. The pitch. And now this one's a rocket to right. Way back there. Gone. So up next, Chaz McCormick. Next pitch is downstairs.
This is the guy they turn to get the most important outs of the ball game, but they're going to make him work to get this save.
Next offering upstairs.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Righty delivers, and that's ball four.
Well, that'll bring the tying run to the plate, so all eyes on the man coming at the dish right now.
So next up for Houston, Jeremy Peña. The tying run at the plate. Hit in the air, right field. Marte gets there. He's under it. Drops into the glove. Two away. At the plate is the Astros catcher, Martin Maldonado.
Martin Maldonado.
New York just one out away, trying to close it out. And a count one and two. Next pitch is popped up. Ball game.
Well, he does a nice job of coming in and getting the save. He made a mistake with the pitch, gave up the solo home run, but he maintained his focus to push through to the finish line.
And this one ends with a final score of 6-4. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciampi saying so long.
The final line score for our ball game tonight for the victorious New York Mets. 6 runs, 9 hits, no errors. They left 10 men on base.